By the grace of Lord Sri Krishna, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, was born a pure devotee. In 1933, Prabhupada was accepted as a disciple by a bona fide spiritual master and ordered to spread Krishna consciousness to the English-speaking world. Then in 1965, at the age of 70, Prabhupada, a renounced saintly person with neither friends nor money, came from India to New York City to fulfill the instructions of his spiritual master. Prabhupada was destined to spark a revolution in consciousness, to ignite the Hare Krishna explosion. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Transcendental knowledge was first spoken by the Lord Himself and has been passed down since that time from spiritual master to disciple in an unbroken chain. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bhaktivinod Thakur, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami and Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. In 1966, Prabhupada founded the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, or ISKCON, widely known as the Hare Krishna Movement. Prabhupada translates on a dictaphone original Sanskrit and Bengali scriptures into English. The tapes are then sent to ISKCON Press in New York. The entire operation, from typing to illustrating to printing, is carried out by the Krishna devotees, all of whom serve without salary. Sri Juta Padakamalam. The message is love of Krishna. Krishna is recognized as God by all the great saints in the scriptures of India. He is the all-attractive person in the reservoir of pleasure. To pass on the science of self-realization, Prabhupada is presenting the Bhagavad Gita as it is, the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Nectar of Devotion, and many other philosophical works. From a Los Angeles warehouse, these literatures are shipped to centers in the United States and abroad. Within a few years, Prabhupada and his disciples have organized an ambitious book distribution program that every year sees thousands of tons of books distributed around the world. The Krishna devotees say that by reading these books and chanting the names of God, a person can attain God consciousness even in this difficult and disturbed age. The most popular mantra is the now familiar Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. This chanting resounds from London to Mexico City, from Paris to Tokyo, from New York to Nairobi. London, thousands flock to attend ISKCON's annual Rathayatra Festival. This festival is held in major cities around the world. Constantly traveling, Prabhupada often makes personal appearances. Here he is introduced to a new Delhi audience by the Canadian High Commissioner and garlanded by a leading citizen.
Everything that we see that is created by God, so you should at least recognize that it is God's property. But they are thinking their property. So there must be no restriction.
Is there a Prabhupada says God is great and we are very small. He is the supreme proprietor and everything should be used in his service. All living creatures are sons of God and are therefore equal. Thus Krishna consciousness is beyond any sectarian and national limitations and is the perfect peace formula. Prabhupada denounces so-called gurus who claim to be God. Such gods are very cheap. I am not God, and you are not God. We are all eternal servants of God.
Being separated from Krishna, they do not know. We are part and parcel of God, or Krishna. We are not in jail.
We asked Jadarani Devi Dasi, one of the artists at ISKCON Press, to tell us about her involvement in the Hare Krishna movement.
So I met Srila Prabhupada in 1967, and I was up in his apartment, and the first thing that he said to me, because previously I was thinking that I didn't know what I was supposed to do, so he said, when you reach the top, then everything else is included. So that sort of answered all questions. It's like if you have $1 million, then all of your $10 problems are solved. So he was implying that when you become Krishna conscious, then all of your other desires and aspirations and ambitions, everything is fulfilled just by taking to the process of Krishna consciousness. And then he asked if I could come to his morning classes. And then I started coming. And then when he saw that I had a propensity for painting, so he gave me two businesses. He said, just be attached to Krishna and to painting. So this is Keshava. Keshava is the name of Krishna. And it means one who wears fine hair. So God has hair, he has a face, he has a body, he's not impersonal. He's the creator and the maintainer and destroyer of everything. And he's the dearmost friend of every living entity. And before you're asking how my consciousness has changed, but just like a lily leaf or something like that that's on the water, even though it's on the water, it's not touched by the water. So even though we're in the material world, because we're working for a pure devotee and for Krishna, we're not touched and we feel satisfied. Satisfied to be in association with Krishna's lotus feet.
Hare Krishna.
Another engagement is the making of spiritual sky incense. The Krishna devotees believe that since everything belongs to Krishna, everything can be used in his service, including business. Spiritual Sky Scented Products Company is a commercial enterprise started by Srila Prabhupada's disciples to gather funds for use in spreading Krishna consciousness. The company markets and manufactures incense, oils, shampoos, soaps, and other scented products. Spiritual Sky has doubled its profits each year since 1969 and is now America's leading incense manufacturer. A computer at the Los Angeles factory keeps the accounts, checks inventory, and bills incense orders. And like any other Krishna devotee, chants Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
10,000.
What's the lead time on the stick pads?
Well, the thing is that the board takes about 6 weeks to get this type of material.
6 weeks. Prabhupada's disciples handle all aspects of the operation, from dipping the sticks in scented oils to packaging, sales, distribution, and manufacturing display racks.
So the quantity of incense.
One sandalwood, they want 12,000 sandalwood.
Where did you get your order?
Upstairs, I got it.
Yeah.
From the Los Angeles factory, Spiritual Sky products are shipped to temples around the world. I never expected such a big business to blossom, Prabhupada has often said. Now it is our duty to use it to serve Krishna. When people buy Spiritual Sky products, they will automatically think of Krishna and be benefited. Los Angeles is not only the center of incense manufacturing, it is also ISKCON's Western World headquarters. The devotees assemble daily at 4:30 a.m. before the deities of Radha and Krishna.
Chant 16 hours at least.
At the time of initiation, the disciple vows to abstain from extramarital sex, intoxication, meat eating, and gambling. Initiation and marriage rites are performed by ancient Vedic fire sacrifice.
Swaha, 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 om.
Initiates also vow to chant some 25,000 names of God daily, a two-hour feat, and to serve the spiritual master without reservation. Marriage means working together in Krishna consciousness. We asked a young husband why he joined the Krishna consciousness movement.
As a student, I was sensitive to the problems confronting our society, and I could see that our leaders were unable to deal with them. Despite their promises for materialistic advancement, I could see that the people were becoming more and more dissatisfied. Even though we are very advanced materially, something very basic is missing in our way of life. By understanding Krishna consciousness, I realized that here was a philosophy that could fill the gap in our materialistic culture. By providing scientific, practical understanding of God, Krishna consciousness can give meaningful purpose to life, and it is the duty of the leaders to provide this educational instruction to the people. Therefore, I have begun the process of Krishna consciousness, and I advocate it as a practical solution to the problems of our modern technological society.
Some of the women learn the devotional art of making dresses for the deity of Krishna and his consort Radha. Milk, grains, fruit, and vegetables are bought wholesale by the society and sold to its members at nominal prices. Devotees shop and prepare food for their families in a spirit of service to Krishna. The children are taught to see Krishna, or God, as the central point in life.